Now, if you'd like to know about the owner of this facility, well, he's called Greg. Now, Greg is always dreamed when he was a child of being a robot enhancement facility owner, because after all, when he was a child, he fell into the most dangerous of situations and required many robot replacement limbs. Now, what happened to poor Greg was one day on a miking expedition, not a hiking as I was originally going to say, but I'm now rolling with miking. He went on a miking expedition, and in this miking expedition, he rocked the mic so hard with such furious raps, such like powerful MC grace, that his lips fell off. Yeah, he rapped so hard his lips fell off. So while he was rapping like really, really hard, I'm trying really hard to pronounce my P's properly because I don't want to say, while Greg was raping really, really hard, his lips fell off, because that just really, I don't want to offend people because that's not funny, although that's quite hilarious. Ah, God. So while he was rapping really hard, you know, with his like, I'm Greg, you're a dreg, I am the rapper. In the future, rap's dead a little bit, so it doesn't take that much to be a good rapper as it stands, so that's why that was considered really, really good rapping. So yeah, so he's Greg, the opponent was a dreg in the future, so he rapped really hard and then his lips fell off, so he went to go get cybernetic lips. Now, what cybernetic lips are really quite good, because they allow you to have the jaw strength of a small great white shark, and Greg loved this because his parents were marine biologists, futuristic marine biologists, so they of course studied bionic animals, because in the future the human race replaced every animal with a bionic version of the animal, because we thought, you know what, it's not dangerous enough, let's try and cause an apocalypse, because then we can fight off bionic animals and generally have a good time. Having a good time. So bionic animals were a thing. The agencies didn't really like it because they thought it was abusing animals, but then they shut up when the government had them killed, because of course in the future the government has the power to have people killed, because it is, as I said, the dictatorship of Rajika. See, you see how that's come together. So Greg, his parents were fighting bionic sharks one day, and he lost a limb to a bionic shark. It's actually kind of ironic, because he couldn't shout for help from the bionic shark because his lips had fallen off, so he was just there going because for some reason Greg needed his lips to speak, so Greg was there not being able to call for help while fighting off this bionic shark, and effectively what happened is he lost his arm, which meant he needed more bionic replacement limbs. So he went to an organic facility. Now this was ironic, because he lost an arm, he wasn't yet able to properly carry a bag of organic cereal that his cybernetic animal marine biologist parents were purchasing. So what he did, right, was he half picked one up and he realized it was too much for his one arm, dropped the bag of incredibly heavy iron filing cereal, because we're all badasses in the future, and then ended up crushing his foot. So as you can see, right, Greg really started off his early life on the wrong foot. Don't worry, that was an armless joke. So he finally convinced his parents to allow him to go to the facility, and he finally arrived, and he walked in to the limb replacement facility, and generally was considered a all-around about great patient. The secretary thought he was great, which was of course a good thing to get on with other humans. It turns out in the future you're allowed to hire complete psychos to do work, which basically meant that the secretary stabbed him a little. So he's rapped so hard his lifts came off. He lost his lifts because, of course, his grandparents were mechanical engineers who made futuristic lifts. And basically, one day, Greg was in one of those lifts, and the lift came off, and he was like, no! Grandparents! And then he fell, and, you know, he lost his other arm. So at this point, he's in a real... I don't know how he's still alive, really. Greg was a good un. He really, like was hard to kill, was Greg. You know what he's like, is Greg. You know Greg. God. Okay. So yeah, he's in a bad state. So he needs replacement organs now and everything. So he thinks, fuck it, full cyborg me. So he goes through the very facility that he now owns, and he gets the best limbs and the best treatment he's ever had. So from that moment onwards, he disregards his parents' dreams that he follows in their footsteps and becomes a professional future ball player, and decides that, you know what, I'm going to own my own limb correction facility, and it's going to be absolutely amazing. So that's indeed what Greg does, and that's the story of Greg, the owner of this facility, everyone. I think you can all clearly see how Greg came to be, his tragic backstory, the lowest, I don't know, I'm so sorry!